Welcome back to Good Morning Blocko. You've probably seen them on the local news. You've heard of them being in just about everything. And for decades, they've been public enemy number, well, probably like number 6 or 7. Today, we sit down with who some are calling a poison to our children. Let's bring them out. So Led, tell us, why do you feel the need to ruin everything? I've just been told that Led was arrested for incessant exposure. We'll have more on Led after this. Cue the intro. Hey there. Welcome to Life, Noggin. We've known about the harmful effects of Led for centuries, and have had bans on its use for decades. But each year, millions of children continue to have dangerous levels of lead in their blood. And in the US, nearly 200 children require treatment for lead poisoning every year. So what is lead poisoning? And why is it still happening? The toxic effects of lead have been documented since the Roman Empire, but because of its versatility, it was used in practically everything, like makeup, spermicide, chastity belts, food and wine seasoning, plates and cups, paint, gasoline, and plumbing. Back then, its effects were referred to as madness, but now we know that it harms the brain and central nervous system and can cause coma, convulsions, and death. Children under 6 are particularly vulnerable, as it can severely affect their mental and physical development, resulting in intellectual disability and behavior disorders that are thought to be irreversible. In the early 1900s, lead-containing paint was identified as the primary source of lead exposure, and countries began to ban it from toys and cribs, and eventually banning its use entirely. Other major sources include water pipes made from lead, which were banned in the US in 1986, and airborne particles from leaded gasoline, which was banned in 1996. This has helped a lot, and research has found that around the time it was removed from gasoline, blood lead levels dropped about 78%. But not every country has bans on lead usage, and even in those that do, they can't reverse the damage that's already been done. About 29 million homes in the US still contain lead paint. More than 9 million still get water through lead pipes. And many urban areas still have lead in the soil from the deposits of gas and paint. Black and low-income communities are particularly affected by these sources. Scientists have determined that there's no safe blood lead level, and any exposure is dangerous. If levels do go over 3.5 micrograms per deciliter, the source should be found and eliminated, and the child should be monitored closely. Cases where levels exceed 45 are the most severe and are treated by chelation therapy. This uses drugs that bind to metals in the blood and are then peed out. But since the effects of lead poisoning may be irreversible, avoiding sources of lead altogether is the best line of defense. Me, Blocko, and this morning good. Triangle Bob, very the best. Okay, Triangle Bob, we talked about this. You're not allowed to run the teleprompter. So tell me, do you or have you lived in a house with lead paint or lead pipes? How has it affected you? Let me know in the comment section below or tell me, what should I talk about next? Click here to watch this video we did on the zombie cell problem happening inside you, or click here to watch this video. Click subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified every single time we upload a new video. And also click like, because it really helps us out. Definitely check out the amazing work by Lifespan, the team that powers Life Noggin, in the description. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.